Hi, welcome back at a new workout. Today we're going to do a cardio Tabata style workout. You don't need any equipment and there's no jumping exercises in this workout and also no repeating exercises. So get ready and let's start. Okay, we're going to start this workout with a short warming up. Just start with the side steps and arm circles. We do four different kinds of exercises in this warming up. And then we go over to the main workout. And the main workout consists of six different sets of exercises. We do three sets before the water break and the other three sets after a short water break. Every set consists of two different exercises, and we do that in Tabata style. So 20 seconds on and then 10 seconds active rest. Reverse your arm circles to the front. Keep making those side steps. Step in circle. Just a few more and then we go over doing some leg swings. Get the blood flowing a little bit, loosen up the muscles a bit. Last one on right, and final on left. Now over to the leg swings. Just swing your leg front, step, and swing. Swing front, swing back, and then place your feet back on the floor. And swing over, left. Swing, and left. Swing, keep your upper body straight up. Just swing your leg in front and to the back and then switch over to your other leg. Keep on swinging. A few more. Over to the right. Swing it. And final on left. Final on right. And now we come into a wide stand position. Going to do some pulse squats. So we're going down and coming up. Down, two, three, four, and up. You don't have to go deep. Just pulse it a little bit. Press your knees to the outside and coming up. We want to get the blood flowing in the legs. Getting the heart rate up a little. So you can do every exercise of this main workout in your own pace. 20 seconds on, 10 seconds active rest to re-catch your breath a little. Up. And we're almost there. Do one final exercise in this warming up. Come on up. Last one. And up, that's it. Okay, feet are on hip wide. What we're going to do is some flutter heel raises. So come on your toes, lift your heel up, and then reverse to the other side. Up. Alternating from left to right. Keep your upper body straight up and curl and extend your arms as well. Final exercise of the warming up. So we're about to go starting that main workout. And the first set of exercises is a combination of the over the tops. We do a double side step with arm circle and a V-step extensions with the arms. You can just follow me along. There are no hard moves in this workout, so you can pick it up very easily. A few more, and that's it. Okay, shake it out and get ready. So main workout is a double side step over the top. And while we do that, we circle the arms. That's it. And the other one is the V-step with the arm extensions. So we extend and close over the top. So come on, double side step with arm circles. We do that 20 seconds. So circle up above your head, big circles. And while we make those circles, we do a double side step. That's it. And final one to the left. And have your 10 seconds rest. In the 10 seconds rest, try to re-catch your breath a little, but stay active. Make side steps. We're going over again. Double. Side steps and circle above your head. Both arms are circling to the left side, over to the right side. Final to the left and finish to the right side and active rest. The next exercise is that V step. We step out wide, small back, and we extend the arms. Come on, left and start with right. Start with left, start with right. That's it. Out wide and small back. Keep your arms up on shoulder height and just extend your arms and bring your hands back to your chest. Lower down. 10 seconds active rest. And we're going to repeat the V step with the arm extensions. Starting with left, get ready and go. So out, out, in, right, left, right. Elbows are up on shoulder height, upper body is straight up, and pull your belly button in. Left and right. Last one. And lower your arms down. Okay, back to the over the tops. Double side steps with arm circles. Get ready and go to the right. Double and circle. Double, circle to the left, circle to the left. Ha, that's it. Big circles all the way over. Last one and have your rest. So take a deep breath in and stay active. Don't stand still. Moving over, going again. All right, stand. Hop, double. To the right, to the left. Big circles. To the right, to the left. Final one, finish to the right side. That's it. Okay, and now over to the V steps, final one, and then we go over to the second set of exercises. Come on, starting on the right. Extend and close. Wide, small. Out, out, in. That's it. Make that V shape. Right, left. Left, right. You got it. And lower your arms down. 10 seconds rest. And then one more time, the V step exercise. So getting ready, starting with left this time, going out left and right. Keep your elbows up, shoulders low. Left, right, right, left. Extend, extend. And the last one. And lower your arms down. Second round of exercises is a combination of the jack steps and a back extension. First, jack steps. So you tap out from side to side and pumping up the arms up above your head and all the way down, touching your outer thighs. Slightly bend your standing leg and tap as far to the side as you can. Last one and 10 seconds rest. So we're going to repeat the jack steps one more time and then over to a back extension twist. Back extension twist. That's the next exercise, but first, jack steps. That's it. Arms up and down. Up and down, up and down. Come on, pump it up. Get a heart rate up. Tap to the side. 5 seconds. And that's it. Okay, the next exercise, like I said, cross your arms, back extension, so bend over. When you come up, you twist in and tap back. So come on, bend over, twist to the left. Bend over, twist to right. That's it. So bend over, keep your back straight. When you come up, you twist in that upper body and tap your leg to the back. Hop, bend over, tap back. That's it. One more, and 10 seconds active rest. going to repeat the back extensions with the twist one more time. So get ready, feet on hip wide, cross your arms, extend, hop, and twist. Bend over, twist, and watch over your shoulder when you make that twist. Engage your abs, up, twist over, keep your back straight, up. Last one, that's it. Repeating the jack steps and the back extensions one more time for that second round. Going over to the jack steps. Get ready? Go. Tap to the side. Bump the arms up and down. Left, right, left, halfway there. Come on, slightly bend the standing legs and tap to the side. Last one, and that's it. Repeating the jack steps another time, 20 seconds, and then over to the back extensions with the upper body twist. Get ready and go. Step it and pump those arms up and down, all the way up above your head, all the way down, touching your legs. Come on, 20, 10 seconds left. Halfway there. Up, down, up, down. And the last one, that's it. Okay, stay active, re-catch your breath, over to the back extensions with that upper body twist. Feet on hip wide, cross your arms and go over, twist. So when you make that extension, up and twist up. Halfway there, in that first round. Twist your upper body, step back. Last one, and that's it. 10 seconds rest, then over to the back step one more time, and then already third round of exercises. Cross your arms, bend over, and tap. So make that extension and upper body twist. We're going over to the third set of exercises, and that's a combination of a pulse lunge and a high knee side crunch. Last one, that's it. So what we're going to do is a pulse lunge, and we extend the arms. We do 20 seconds on one leg. So right is in front, left is behind. Pulse down and up. You don't have to go deep. It's all about the cardio. So pulse it, upper body straight up. Arms are in a 90 degree angle, and you lift your elbows up on shoulder height. The next 20 seconds, left feet in front. Last one, come on up. That's it. Next 20 seconds, your left is in front. So small pulses up and down. Don't have to go deep. And bring your arms up, working the shoulders. Go down. So just pump it up and down. Keep your upper body straight up. Lift your elbows up on shoulder height. That's it. 5 seconds. Last one, that's it. The next one is a combination of a high knee side crunch. 20 seconds on left, the next 20 seconds on right. So get ready and go. High knee, crunch, that's it. So you bring the knee up towards the chest and then bring it to the outside, elbow down, knee up. Great one for the core, getting that heart rate up. Stay on the left side. Last one, that's it. Okay, next 20 seconds on that right side. So keep going, find your balance, hands up and go right. Up, so bring the knee towards your chest and then to the outside, crunching that upper body over to the right side. Halfway there, up front, side. That's it, last one. Ah, very well done. Going to do these two exercises one more time, then you have your water break. So we're going back into that pulse lunge. Right is in front and go down, up. Raise your elbows up, pulse it up and down. Get your heart rate up. Keep your upper body straight up. And like I said, you don't have to go deep. Working your legs, your glutes, your shoulders, and your condition. Last one. Next 20 seconds, left leg is in front. So make that wide stand. Get ready and pulse it down. Make yourself your fist. Bend your arms in that 90 degree angle. And raise your elbows up on shoulder height. Halfway there, come on. Up and down, pump it up. And the last one, that's it. Over to the high knee side crunch, starting on left. So it's the final minute, then you have that water break. Find your balance and go left. Hop, front, crunch to the side. Bend that upper body, bring your elbow down, knee up. Find your balance and keep your upper body straight up. Lift the knee. Yes, one more on left. And that's it. 10 seconds active rest. Final one, 20 seconds on the right side. So find your balance again and go. Knee up, side, knee, side. That's it. Come on, bring your knee towards your chest. Find your balance. Crunch your upper body to the side. Great one for your core. Balance and that heart rate is up. Last one. Front, side, and that's it. Very well done. You finished the first 3 sets of exercises. Now make sure you drink some water, recatch your breath, and I'll see you in the next round. We do 3 different sets of exercises. Okay, here we go for the second round of exercises. The first combination is a squat, twist up, lift up the heel, and the other one is a double front kick. We start with a squat and twist. So squat down, twist up. And when you twist up, bring that arm down, making that extension. Twist up, bring that heel up, squat down, squeeze the glute. That's it. From side to side. Twisting in. Last one, that's it. Doing this another 20 seconds, then over to a double front kick. So double with left, double with right. But first, squat and twist. Squat it down, twist up. Extend your arm, hop. Twist in, lift the heel up. From right to left, right to left. Press the knees a little bit to the outside when you make that squat. Last one, and that's it. Over to a double front kick. So we kick in front twice. You don't have to kick high, just a double kick. And keep your upper body straight. So step it left, kick it right. Hop, hop. Double with left, double with right. Keep your upper body straight up. And just kick in front of you. Double right, double left. Kick it. Last one, and that's it. Doing the kicks one more time, then back over to the squat twist. Stay active, and find your balance, kick it. Double on right, double on left. Move your arms along, come on, active. Kick, double. Double kick on right, double kick on left. Hop, kick up. Final ones, and that's it. Over to the squat and twisting. So come into that wide stand. Toes are a little bit pointing to the outside and squat it down. Twist, twist and extend. So keep your upper arm still and push your arm down. That's it. Twist, twist. Bring that hip from left to right. Last one, that's it. 10 seconds active rest. Now repeating the squats one more time. Wide stand, deep breath in and go down. Squat it, extend and twist. There you go, keep going. Squat it down and twist. 5 seconds and then over to the double front kicks. Last one and come on up. Take a deep breath in, recast your breath a little. And you're going over to the double front kick, starting with left. Okay, ready? Double. Right. And left. So come on, lift your leg up and kick it. Keep your upper body straight up. Engage your abs so belly button is in. And kick it. Right, left, and final ones. That's it. Okay, few seconds rest, and then one final kicks, and then we go over to another round, another set of exercises. Get ready, start on right, kick it. Double, on left, double on right. Keep that upper body straight up. Move your arms, curl and extend. On left, double, final on right, and that's it. Next deck of exercises, front step with the pushes, and then butt kicks. Single one, so wide stand, go down a little, tap it front, and push it. That's it. So stay down a little, keep your upper body straight up, back is straight, belly button is in, and push in front with power. On chest height, tap, 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 last one, and come on up. 10 seconds active rest, and then we're going down, tapping in front again. So feet on hip wide, go down and tap it. Tap and push, come on. Engage your abs, belly button in, and power in your arms. Push and pull back. Stay down, don't come up yet. Last one, and coming up. Next one is a butt kick. We're coming in a wide stand, we bring the heels towards the butt, and while we do that, we cross and pull back. So cross your arms, kick it. Wide stand, knees are slightly bent. You make little pulses from right to left, bringing the heels up, and then cross your arms when you kick. That's it. Make yourself the fists and pull back. Last one, and come on up. 10 second rest, and then I'm going to repeat the butt kickers. In that wide stand, and cross your arms, go again. Right, left, right, left. So keep your knees slightly bent, stay down a little bit, and kick it. 10 seconds, come on, pull back with power. That's it, kick it. Last one, and that's it. Over to the low front taps with the pushes again. So, going down, feet on hip wide, and go, tap and push. So don't come up, stay down, tap your toes in front, and push your arms in front. On chest high, come on, belly button is in, engage your abs, keep your back straight. Final ones. And come on up. 10 seconds active rest. Stay active. Don't stand still. You're going to repeat the front taps one more time. Going down again and tap it. Push, push, push. So push and pull. Come on. Keep the heart rate up. Five steps. And stay down. Final seconds. Last one. And come on up. Over to the butt kicks for 2 times 20 seconds and then over to the final set of exercises. Cross your arms and kick it. So wide stand, knees slightly bent. Bring the heels up towards your butt. Create one for your hamstrings. Backside of your legs and pull back with power. So cross pull, that's it. Last one, and that's it. Okay, you're going to do this another 20 seconds. So recast your breath a little, into that wide stand again, bend your knees, cross your arms, and go, kick it. From left to right, left, right. Kick it. 10 seconds. You can do this. Keep your upper body straight up. Keep kicking. Final ones. And that's it. Shake it out. Final set of exercises. A windmill step. Arms are up. We step out. Tapping the toes. So come on. Stepping out to left. Come center. Arms up to right. So you step out. Bend over. And tap your toes. If you can't tap your toes, just step your knees from side to side. Choose your option, but come on up. And the last one, that's it. Lower your arms down. Doing this windmill taps one more time. So get ready, arms up, step it out. From right to left. So bend over, cross in, twist in that upper body. Tap your toes. 10 seconds. From side to side. Final on right. Finish on left. And lower your arms down. The next one is the low side tap. So what we're going to do is we extend our arms. Stay down low and tap it. Come on, follow me. Tap it. Tap it. So stay down on those standing legs. Tap to the side. And while you do that, extend your arms. Right, left, right. That's it. Stay down low. Pump your arms up and down. Last one. And come on up. So when you make that exercise, you can lean over a little bit, but make sure you keep your back straight. Going again. Bend over and go. Tap. Extend. Most important, stay down low a little bit and pump it. Get a heart rate up. Left, right, left. Come on. Pump it, extend your arms. Last one, and come on up. Okay, final round. Windmill steps and low side steps. Arms up, getting ready, step out to right. Step down and come up. Step it out, a big step from side to side. Bend over and touch your toes or your knees. From right to left, keep your arms up. Last one, and lower your arms down. All right, get your breath a little. Going to do this one more time, starting on that left side. So arms up and go. From left, up to right. So come all the way up, arms up on shoulder height, and then tap over, left to right. Final seconds. Last one on left, and that's it. Okay, we finished this workout with the low side step. We're doing twice, so one more minute. Go down and tap it. Low side taps. Extend your arms. Come on, pump it. 10 seconds. Don't come up yet. Pull that belly button in. Keep your back straight. Last one. And come on out. Okay, only 20 seconds left. Then we go to a little bit of cooling down and stretching. So get ready. Go down. And there you go. Finish strong. Final seconds. Pump it. Speed up. Right, left, right, left. Yes, there you are. 10 seconds. Pump it. Tap, tap, tap. Yes, come on. And that's it. Come on up. You did a great job. Now it's time to recover. So make some side steps. Upper body straight up. Low down your shoulders. Open your chest. And take 2, 3 deep breaths in to slow down your heart rate. Re-catch your breath. And while you're doing those side steps, we're going to add a shoulder roll. Slow down the pace. That's it. You finished that main workout. You did a hell of a job. You can be very proud of yourself. Now it's time to recover. So slow down that heart rate, make the shoulder rolls, and we're going to reverse. So shoulder roll to the front, to the front. Bring the shoulder up towards your ear and bring it in front. Roll, roll, that's it. We did a lot of arm movements, up and downs, very fast pace at the end. So really challenging yourself. So come on into a little wide stand. And then slowly, slightly bend your knees. We're going to stretch the shoulder. So when you're ready, left arm in front, pull it towards your chest, keep your shoulder low, and then you can feel that stretch in the front side of your shoulder and a little bit in your shoulder blades. So shoulders are down low and press that arm against your chest. Keep your upper body straight up and just keep breathing in and out and lower your heart rate a little bit further. That's it. Swing it out. Same on the right side. Arm in front, shoulder low, and press that arm against your chest. Feel that stretch and just enjoy it. And that's it. Release. Okay. A little wider stance. Slightly bend the knees, and we're going to rotate the hips. So hips are going to left. Press forward over to right. Big circles, and your upper body is going along. Circling from left to the front. Slightly bending knees. Release the tension out of your hips, your knees. And reverse from left over to the right side. Rotate, push back to the right, in front. Rotate your upper body with it, up. One more, and that's it. Shake out your legs. We're going to do one final stretch. Your right leg is in front, your left is behind. And what we are going to do is we stretch out the legs and we bend that upper body over, bringing the chest towards the knees. As far as we can, and you can feel that stretch in your glute, your hamstrings. So keep your back straight and bring the chest towards your knees. And hold it when you feel that stretch in your glutes, in your hamstrings. And now slightly bend your knees, roll up, and then bring the left in front, your right behind. Stretch out your legs. And bend over straight back and bring that chest towards your knees, towards your legs, as far as you can. And feel that stretch again in your left glute, your left hamstring. Hold it a few more seconds. Okay, slightly bend your knee, roll up, and that's it. Very well done. You finished another workout. Give yourself that well deserves thumbs up. Be proud of yourself. And of course, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Let me know if you like it or not. And of course, I hope to see you next time in another workout. Invite your friends, of course, to work out with us. And I wish you a very pleasant day today.